follow his decision.
I used them all up. You should have seen us at our rehearsal yesterday for 3 hours. We looked really good.
We actually rehearsed yesterday. I mean, we went through 2 hours worth of songs in 3 hours. That's really good for us.
We've got more old stories than you can possibly imagine.
Because we're old.
Because we're old, and there are four of us. So, and it's not a linear relationship. It's a hyperbolic relationship. The older you get and the more old people you get together, the number of stories goes up exponentially.
And we didn't even talk about, health issues.
Health issues!
That's good.
Oh, man. Yeah.
We actually did talk about colonoscopy sometimes.
But that was just because of scheduling.
That was just to cheer us up.
So, if anybody needs a colonoscopy, I went to AutoZone and I got this little thing.
You know, one of those cameras?
Yeah, I'd see around corners.
John,
you like that, didn't you?
Colonoscopies for dummies.
Yeah. That would be the ones for us.
So my brother and sister are supposed to come.
I hope so.
And my brother's friend from high school.
We'll go out and see what they are.
And whatever that is.
I'm not sure we have one of those in my hometown.
Go ahead and order a coffee.
Friends from high school.
Yeah,
high school. Oh, high school. Well, you work in Florida.
Yeah.
What was that song I played? I played that weird chord yesterday.
So it's really good to see everybody tonight. We appreciate y'all coming out in the rain and so forth.
Yay, Wayne! Did y'all eat some of Jason's sandwiches? He's got great food here.
John ate one of the apple fritters, and he got new strings, and they're already dirty and sticky.
Yeah, they got
stuff
take all
them anywhere.
All over my strings.
Did you drink your beer?
I don't remember.
Well, if you did, we're honored.
I'll have to ask Mrs. Miller. Sometimes she sneaks in.
Of course, I'm amazed. We're not getting paid yet. We're not on the clock.
On the clock? Well, I've got some people who said they were going to be here. They're not hitting it.
Oh, dear. We're going to start calling them up.
There's a bunch of people that...
post on Facebook.
You know, if we were fashionable musicians, we would wait till 8:30 to start.
And then take a 45-minute break.
I've never been late for anything in my whole life. Ever.
I went out to dinner, and there was a young lady playing music. And so we were there maybe an hour, and she was on her second break. You know, within an hour.
Oh,
so,
that reminds me. Yeah, if any of these folks out here are going to go to the bathroom, you better do it right now because we may not stop.
We got a lot of music to cover.
That's what my dad used to say when we were on a trip. We're not stopping. Throw it out the window.
Throw it out back.
Or you want to wait for your friend?
Casey, we only got like for us to start.
We only got.
Whittling down the time very nice.
Yeah, you know.
Half as many minutes as the last time you asked.
That's good.
So has everybody got an impeachment fever out there?
Yeah.
We can always hope.
We could, I guess.
Only
if we did it. We might know it later.
We might make it up. Charles, play some. Sure, why not? We can't wait any longer.
2 minutes.
I can't wait.
You gotta introduce this, Jason. Or do you want to
Y'all got my microphone.
What's that?
Y'all have my microphone.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
if Jason had a microphone, he would say, "Ladies and gentlemen, the four-man string band."
Yay! Direct from the reality show.
Y'all sing with us. Get this feeling I may know. Thank you.
All right, well, we are here. And we're going to play a few songs for you. We're going to do a song that George wrote here.
This is a song about hope.
And it features dual mandolins.
How many songs?
Is that coming through okay?
Yes.
Thank you.
So sometimes we play country music.
He also runs the sound. Let's hear it for Jason.
Yay!
Waller.
And he cooked all of the sandwiches, and I'm sure he made the apple fritters, and they're delicious. And if you don't believe it, it's all over this thing.
You licked your finger. Oh, you didn't, we're supposed to hear that. So.
No, yeah, you're supposed to move away from the microphone.
Well, it did, but it worked.
We're going to play the same song that we think we're playing, right?
Yeah.
We do have a set list.
We got a set list.
Tom Paxton, right?
Yeah. He was a man, never friend of the place. He hung with me.
Don't sing along with our
old days. He never cared if he had another. Your rambling bring you joy. town. The chance to stray, thought we'd try to work on a day. The boss said we had room for one. Says my old pal, we'd rather bum. Here's to you,
some blues harmonica.
Clark's causing a kerfuffle over here. He's damaging equipment back here, and part of it's my own, so I'm very patient with him. He's more worried about his than mine. I don't know why that is.
This is a song that Dylan wrote called Watching the River Flow.
Why only yesterday I saw somebody on the street. couldn't help but cry. Well, that old river keeps on rolling over, no matter what gets in the way or which way the wind blows. And as long as it does, I'm gonna sit here and watch that river flow.
Sally, you gonna sing with us?
I've been singing
the whole time. I can't hear
you, darling. We like Nancy Griffith, don't we?
Yeah, you do.
She dies, he says.
Is a song by Chuck Brodsky, who's a songwriter of some renown. You may or may not have heard of him. If you get a chance to see him, I've never seen him, but if you get a chance to see him, you should take him in. He's written a lot of interesting songs. This is a song that's
What was that?
We're going to play this.
You know, last week we were playing at a church.
Y'all are going to love this song because it's about renewal and reuse of materials. And we're going to play this in Dawsonville tomorrow, so listen to the words really carefully. And if we don't come back from Dawsonville, you're going to know why.
But I first heard the song done by a fellow named Jerry Bruner, who plays with a group called Just Because. You all know him? Yeah, if you have a chance to see them or see Jerry, you should take advantage of that. So this is called Take It Out Back. Y'all ready?
Sure.
Ashes from the wood stove filling up the bucket. Where am I gonna chuck it? Take it out the back door where I never mow. Find a place where no one ever goes. Take it out back, dump it in the river. Take it out back, throw it in the woods. Take it out back, chuck it down the hillside. Keep the front yard looking good. Keep the front yard looking good. It's the pride of the neighborhood.
Are you firing us already?
Well, it's because we miss you, you know, when you're not here.
You can slide an exit under that counterweight. It will help. Now I've got to grow taller every few minutes.
He whines continuously.
And right, I like how he fixes it right before a song I don't sing
on. Jason is Clark's personal sound man.
But it's fine.
You should hear what he says when you're over there. All right, we're going to do a geographically correct song. Huh? I'm a civil engineer, so that's kind of an inside joke. I used to be one.
I was never civil.
You were an uncivil engineer.
I've heard them all.
I was just nasty. I was a damn engineer.
I've heard that too.
You still are.
Yeah, I am. All right, this is a... very pretty song, I think, called Darcy Farrow. I first heard it from John Denver. And it's kind of a Romeo and Juliet type song, so be aware there's not a happy ending. Thank you.
Well, they sing of Darcy Farrow, where the Truckee runs through. They sing of her beauty in Virginia City too. At dusky sundown, where they drink around. And two young Bendy, whose love was true.
Thank you. That's Charles Astor, everybody.
What's the H string thing called?
It's a banana.
Oh, God.
you're not going to get anything straight out of any of
this. This is it's a mandolin.
Yeah.
I always say mandolins have
And Clark teaches mandolin, incidentally, if you're interested in it, down at the Frank Hamilton School.
Where is Shelley?
She's hiding all the way out of that.
Shelley's the director of the Frank Hamilton School. And if you want to learn how to play mandolin,
I just want to know what it is.
Well, yeah. But anyway, I always say they have a little. Nobody knows what they look like because I've got five of them, and they're all completely different looks. His looks different than mine, and but you know.
So while George is tuning, I think there's a dance floor in the back, and this next song is just perfect for a slow dance. I'll just warn you ahead of time. Of course, I don't think Jason sells alcohol here. So if
But you can bring your own bottle if you pay extra. Or your own can.
Yeah.
I think he's close to getting a beer and wine license.
That would be referred to as a corkage fee.
Yes, well,
a corkage fee.
Yeah, so, I think Jason's close to getting a beer and wine license.
No, I'm actually serious. This is a great song for slow dancing.
And it's also a great song to bring in illegal substances.
Yeah.
So, well, not that we're supposed to bring them here, but it's a good Georgia song. It's a good country song because it talks about trucks and women.
Well, let's just play the dadgum song.
Well, I think it's... Are you in tune?
What are you guys waiting for anyway?
I've been warped by the rain, driven by the snow, got drunk and dirty, but don't you know that I'm still in every headlight. Oh, Alice, I've been from Tucson to Tucum, Kerry, to Hatchapeake and Tonopah. I've driven every kind of rig now that's ever been made. Driven the back roads so it wouldn't get wet. I've driven every kind of the back row so wouldn't get way. And if you give me wheat, white sand wine, and you show me a sign, I'll be willing to be moving. I've been kicked by the wind, robbed by the sleet, had my head stove in, but I'm still on my feet and I'm still willing. And I smuggle some smokes and folks from Mexico, baked by the sun every time I go to Mexico. Yeah, Mexico. I've been from Tucson to Tucson, Kerry. That had to be a tone of law. I've driven every kind of rig now that's ever been made. Driven the back road so it wouldn't get way. And if you give me wheat, white sand wine, and you show me a sign, oh, I'll be willing.
To the white line of the highway down the middle of the road.
Yeah.
Refers to a little Dexedrine pill.
It does. Don't listen to him.
In college, we used to call them white crosses, but here they refer
now,
to.
Now, there's
white.
A moonshine festival we're singing at tomorrow, so we'll probably sing that song tomorrow.
Yeah, because there's a whole lot of all kind of stuff up in Dawsonville. I can't wait.
And we're also going to sing Take It Out Back.
Yeah, that should be the end of us. So this next one is a tribute to Robert Hunter. He passed away about a week and a half, 2 weeks ago. And you really do have to sing along with this. And I know y'all been faking your kind of singing along up until now, but now you have to really do it.
Sure,
was trailed by 20 hounds. Didn't get to sleep that night till the morning come around. Set out running, gonna take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get to sleep tonight. ran into the devil, babe, and he lonely pretty blue. Spent the night in Utah in a cave up in the hill. Said I'd rather really take my time, a friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. Ran down to the levee and the devil caught me there. Took a $20 bill and he vanished in the air. Said I'd rather really take my time, a friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, I just might get some sleep tonight. Spent my life in jail. Got a wife in Chino, babe, and one in Cherokee. First one says she's got my charm and don't look like me. Said I'm not gonna take my time. A friend of the devil is a friend of mine. If I get home before daylight, just might get some sleep tonight.
Came to us from a friend of ours, Don Fay, who's sitting in the back here.
Taking
yay, John!
Charles, is the one, Charles here is the one that convinced us that that we needed to take it on, and so
I don't think he had convinced us too much.
No, we actually love this song.
Yeah, it's a beautiful song, and you're gonna love it too if you've never heard it before.
It's called Mercy Mine.
Soothe us and tell us and say, Can we pray to some power, some being or force, to soothe us and solve us and save?
School, and this is actually the Frank Hamilton series, artist series. We have a different group from our school play here almost every month, and we're exceptional. We play here three or four times.
That makes us artists.
Yes. And George and I both teach at the school, but I teach this to all of my students. One of my friends came and said, yeah, learn the song. So I did. So it's by Guy Clark. I'd rather sleep in a box, like if I'm on the street, than a fine feather bed without your little purple. Dumb and so blind, let them know that tomorrow will never be mine. And I'd rather die young than to live without you. I'd rather go hungry than eat lonesome stew. You know it's once in a lifetime, and it won't come again. It's here and
if I can't dance with you,
then I won't dance at all. Now sit this one out with my back to the wall, and I'd rather not hear pretty music again if I can't hear. If I can't catch your scent on a magnolia wind.
That beautiful song was written by Guy Clark.
No relation.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my far left is John Miller on the 12-string guitar. This thing is an animal. There on the mandolin and other instruments is Mr. Clark Brown.
Thank you.
And another man here on many instruments, a man of many talents, Mr. George Ecker.
Yay!
Also the prettiest one in the group.
Yeah, baby.
And I'm Charles Absher, and it's important to know that I'm the youngest in the group.
Any boy band has to have the sensitive one, the smart one, the defiant one, and the cute one. Okay, and I call cute right at the beginning.
I'm the profane one.
I haven't figured out what I am yet.
He's finding himself.
In 6 decades,
I don't want to be there when he realizes what he is.
Now, John, be nice.
I was pretty nice. Y'all still gonna let me ride with you tomorrow, right?
Mm-hmm. So far.
I'm in trouble too. Okay, come on. Technical difficulties.
Shoelaces are untied again.
My wife and I listen to NPR. We often have a clock radio set. To NPR, it goes off in the morning. And when I was still
about
working,
10. Oh, <I'm
sorry. laughs> when I was still working, it would go off, and we would sometimes sort of linger in bed and listen to some stories. And one morning, I heard an interview. I need to plug this guitar in. This is just also very complicated. But there was an interview with a homeless man, and I was listening to
it. Looked a lot like us.
If you hear a sizzling noise, run.
It's George Fry up here on stage.
God, I think I've got all my paraphernalia together here now. But anyway, I heard this interview, and I listened to it for a while, and I thought, wow, somebody ought to write a song about this. And then I woke up a little bit, and I realized, oh, I'm a songwriter. And so I wrote a song about this guy. It's called American River. Y'all ready?
Yeah.
You don't want to change your mind about this, do you?
No.
Okay,
all right. Let's play it in D.
I live on the American River. All my money's spent. They won't hire a man who's good with his hands from a city made of tents. Come out to California from the Minnesota coast. Who'd have believed this is where I'd be at 53 years old? So send me a tired and hungry, yearning to be free. Come to the American River, face the future here with me.
think my car got stolen. I ended up in jail. Got drunk that night, got into a fight. Couldn't make the bail. Last fall, my house got foreclosed. Mama took in my wife. I'm a good man with these two hands. I rebuild my life. Send me a tired and hungry, yearning to be free. Come to the American River, taste the future here with me.
This next song is from a choral aria. I found out that's exactly what it is, a choral aria. And it's called Considering Matthew Shepard. And when I first heard the song, you know, you've heard these songs, I don't know, as a performer, as a singer, you hear a song and say, the first time you hear it, I want to do that song. That's what happened with this song. It's called The Innocents. When I think of all the times the world was ours for dreaming, when I think of all the times the earth seemed like our home, every heart alive with its own longing, every future we could ever hope to hold, all the times the laughter rang in summer, all the times the rivers sang our tunes, was there already sadness in the sunlight? Some stormy story waiting to be told. Where, oh, where has the innocence gone? Where, oh, where has it gone? Rain's rolling down, wash away my memory. When I think of all the joys, the times that we remember, all the treasures we believed we'd never, ever lose. Too many days gone by without them meaning. Too many darkened hours without their peace. Where, oh, where has the innocence gone? Where, oh, where has it gone? Vows we once swore, now it's just a letting go. Where, oh, where has it gone? Where, oh, where has the innocence gone? Where, oh, where has it gone? Rain's rolling down, wash away my memory. Where, oh, where has it gone? Now from that to some bluegrass.
Yeah, I gotta get ready for this.
I mean, sort of bluegrass, you know. Four guys out of Liverpool, the most famous bluegrass group in the history of bluegrass.
That's right.
You know, they should have done this way.
Charles. Oh, yeah.
Should have had a mandolin.
Should have had a mandolin. They'd still be together.
Other than two of them have passed.
Well, could have been like just put other people in there. Nobody would know. I mean, actually, Ringo wasn't on the first American tour. They stuck somebody else in there. Go ahead.
Here we go.
One, two,
three.
I've just seen a face I can't forget, the time or place where we just met. She's just a girl for me. I want all the world to see you in fact. Been another day, I might have flipped the other way. I have never been aware, but as it is, I'll dream of her tonight. Da, 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 da. Falling, yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling, he's back again. Falling, yes, I am falling, and she keeps calling. I have never known the likes of this. I've been alone and I have missed and been proud as I am. The other girls were never quite like this.
Thank you.
don't forget to tip your waitresses. Oh, I used to play in a lot of bars. Get something to drink or a sandwich or some great food back there.
It really is awesome. I think I might have eaten the last apple fritter, though.
You should have another one.
This next song is a women's rights history lesson, all rolled into a song. It's got some sing-along to it. Nevertheless, those are easy words, right? And she persisted.
Ready?
Sure.
Sojourner T walked from slavery, beaten and sexually abused. Abolitionist leaders speaking of power with words of truth. Harry T led some people free in the days before the Civil War. Conducting on the Underground Railroad, it's a story you have heard before. Oh, she was warm. Ooh. She was given an explanation. Susan B. and Elizabeth C. led the fight for women's rights. Never gave up the fight. Alice P. and Lucy B. only dared to break their will. Hunger strike, boss fed, night of terror didn't stop them, the dream fulfilled. Oh, they were warm. They were given an explanation. Rosa P. tired of giving in, and she just wasn't gonna give up her seat. Started the Montgomery boycott, beginning Jim Crow's defeat. But now the why she was marked to die, wanting only to live as free. Cowards all plotted her fall, but she was lucky it was not to be. Whoa, she was warned. She was given an explanation. She persisted. She persisted. She persisted. She persisted. She persisted. She persisted. She persisted.
Song.
Yeah, I wrote that song.
And it is. Yeah. George made up this next one.
Yeah, do y'all know where the words came from?
if you're not aware.
Mitch McConnell helped me out with it.
Yeah, they're co-writers.
That's not right, is
like
it?
No.
That's not right.
We decided we're just going to play for 2 hours straight. So if y'all need to.
If you're my age, you can go to the bathroom anytime you need to go.
It's a shame they have to play straight.
Yeah, and I don't think I should mention it, but we have no help up here. So. Never mind.
In the Navy, we used to call that gear adrift.
Another gear malfunction.
We're usually a little bit more organized than this, but that's a big fat lie.
This is a song of mine about a childhood memory. When my granddad retired, he and my grandmother, who were just the loveliest people in the world, moved from Scranton, Pennsylvania to Baltimore, Maryland. And for one summer, on a regular basis, he drove me to Little League games. And so that's what this song is about, called Granddad's Car. Y'all ready? Joseph, swing the bat. Swing the bat. You'll never get a hit if you don't swing the bat. And those are words to live by.
Truer words were never spoken.
Yeah, and your granddad never read Moneyball. He says, stand there and take the ball. Okay, that's totally crazy.
I get it.
I feel sorry for you, whoever that was.
You're my psychic friend now.
So, Bob Dylan wrote a lot of rock and roll songs. No. Another Bob Dylan song, honestly.
Down the street, the dogs are barking, and the days are getting dark. As the night comes and a falling, the dogs will lose their bark. And the silent night will shatter from the sounds inside my mind. And I'm one too many mornings and a thousand miles behind. Of my doorstep, my eyes they start to fade. As I turn my head back to the room where my love and I have laid, and I gaze back to the street, the sidewalks and the sun, and I'm one too many mornings and a thousand. Couldn't tell that, could you?
Sometimes we have practices, and we start at like 12:30, and about 4:30 we go, we've only done like four songs. maybe we don't need to go over.
We're so, going through these pretty fast tonight. We're hardly talking at all, and make fun of the banjo player or anything.
We might actually get through.
We might get through tonight.
We might have to do more songs.
More songs.
We'll have to make up some.
So we're not going to do Free Bird. I just want to tell you that right now.
Or Rocky Top.
We're not going to do Rocky Top. George doesn't like that song. He went to that college over in Athens, and They don't like it when you play Rocky Tom.
We do.
Well, yeah. So this is our same famous bluegrass band from it. So.
Yeah, this one.
I guess it's not a favorite, but we do a lot of Southern bands. So
I just want Sally, you know Les. He says I hate Southern songwriters, and I went and got me a book, and I learned all the Southern song written songs I could find. And every time I see him, I play at least five of them. It's just
with you.
Yeah, I'm in. This is the. The official city song of Macon. And you're welcome to sing along with me. Come and go.
the strains of gypsy flies, the sweet white sound.
Trying to figure out how to get a banjo in, but to save his life, George can't play the banjo and harmonica at the same time.
And we try to get him to sing when he's playing the harmonica.
Yeah, he's really good.
So I guess we're going to take a break for about 3 minutes.
Y'all be really quiet here for a moment.
Go buy some coffee.
Well, after I retired, I went back to the school, back to the North Avenue place, and I took history classes. And there was an old history professor in there that liked to audio tape his lectures. It was a huge lecture hall. You know, it was about half football players and half tennis players because it was the history course. And guess what? It wasn't mechanics of deformable bodies or any of the other good classes.
We used to call that death bonds.
Yeah. So, you know, it was a two-hour class, two-hour lecture, and he gave us a break in the middle. And so here he goes off to the restroom with his microphone still on. There's nothing like a lecture hall with 200 freshman jocks sitting there listening to an old man in the bathroom.
Sticks with you.
And mean old me, when he got back after class, I told him what had happened.
I would want to know.
I bet he was really pissed.
Was he appreciative?
No. He was not appreciative. He was not happy at all about anything that had happened in the previous 2 hours.
What kind of grade did you get in class?
I was the teaching assistant. I was just having a good old time. I was probably responsible for turning his microphone off. Oops.
Okay. We played five songs while you were out.
Oh, did you really?
We could hear you.
Very quickly.
We're edging over troubled waters.
Carl, good. Just good. You were a professor, so you understand.
Absolutely.
Things happen.
I came close to doing the same thing. So.
Okay. I always like it at church when the minister forgets to turn off his, you know, when he's counseling people.
And cursing.
Well, not at my church.
Oh,
well, not that I know of.
Clark's Roman Catholic. I'm Methodist. The preacher cusses all the time.
We like to play it. We played at John's church, what, 3 times so far?
Uh-huh.
And they give us barbecue.
Yeah. But we're going to play in a little while this SUV song, and we took that off the set list for the church, and you'll see why in a little while.
You know,
that's not what we're doing now.
No. Well, you know.
Don't get ahead of yourself, Jim.
George likes to play in drop D tuning, and my feeling is that God put guitars in tune the way they're supposed to be, not. You know, I can't think in a different.
You need to talk to Joni Mitchell then.
Well, you know, I mean,
I want to talk to Joni Mitchell.
That would be wonderful, yeah.
I could see changing the tuning on a mandolin. It would never go back. I mean, it's hard enough to keep them in. This is the reason I play this one. It stays in tune for an hour or so. So we're almost ready. Y'all should have gone taking your break too. Oh, yeah. All right.
Did y'all see my DC ball cap?
Yeah.
They're probably gonna lose tonight because I got this hat on.
Is that too loud?
Yes.
No. No, not?
Okay.
Where my
you. Oh, all right.
We're gonna get ready for the rain.
We're gonna get ready for the rain.
Is it still raining already? It's raining. I'm ready.
I wrote this song just before the 2018 election. It's perfect for the 2020 election too. It's called "Get Ready for the Rain." The chorus is real easy. The fellas here will help you out. I want everybody to sing on it, okay?
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Thank you.
right on schedule?
We're right on schedule.
This is like a first.
How many people drive a SUV in the audience?
Besides me. I don't.
We drive one too.
But we can actually put John's car in my SUV.
This song is not directly directly directed. That was pretty good. Correctly directed to you.
All right, how many? This is not a dual mandolin song like our other one. But when we get to the chorus, I think after you've heard it the first time, you should be able to pick up, and we're going to do the chorus two more times after the first time. And the second time and the third time, y'all have to sing along.
Almost there. There we go. I got my favorite.
And I'm only telling you this to pass the time.
This is a song that I wrote after watching an auto show on TV one time. And I was just like astonished that, you know, there are all these cars with 12 cylinders and you know, 1,000 horsepower and all this kind of stuff. And I was just astounded at the excess. So I wrote this song. It's called Bury Me in My SUV. And the chorus goes, I don't give a damn about the ozone layer as long as it's got a DVD player. I don't give a damn about smog and acid rain. If my vision of reality finally catches up with me, you can bury me in my SUV. So we invite you to sing along.
The sentimental
so
song.
Everybody got that, right?
Yeah. Well, there'll be a test later.
It'll be a test.
You all ready?
Yeah. I wanna drive to my favorite theater. be playing inside your head for a week and you can't turn the volume down on it.
Sorry.
So we've come to the portion of our show that's called the end.
So this is definitely an audience participation. Oh, yeah. Song.
But y'all know this one.
Yeah.
The Liverpool boys.
Well, you know, I hope you don't mind and go over a few minutes, but
sky, Lord.
all of you guys.
Get up, guys.
And if anybody, we have these wonderful four-man string band shirts. We have like three of them. Anybody would like to buy one?
I'm not giving my shirt up.
I don't want you without your shirt.
Yeah, I am.
But anyway, my wife has them. So if you'd like to buy them.
Thank you very much. Thank you for that.
Thank you.
Yeah.